Carmine Sid and I got a plan for you.
Yeah.
We can help you out.
Please get out of my house, Irving. Will you please leave? I'm asking you nicely. Please leave. Get out of my house. Go.
Get out of our house.
I don't want to. Oh, fuck. I'm sorry. I didn't mean for this to happen.
Break my motherfucking heart.
I didn't mean for this to happen.
In front of my family. This is what matters to me most, and you're crushing that. You're going to take me away from them?
I don't want this to happen.
Well, I work beside a man every day. And I can't help but have developed a bit of a crush on him.
Well, who is this man so I can kick his ass?
Well, there's no need to worry. It's been chased. We've never even met. He's a German.
Now I really want to kill him.
How do you mean you work alongside a German?
Well, each of us intercepts messages from a specific German radio tower. So we have a counterpart on the other side who's tip-tapping out the messages. Everyone types a touch differently, so you get to know the rhythm of your counterpart. Strangely intimate.
Where do you stand on politics, Mr. Hughes?
Excuse me.
We're all socialists here.
Oh, we are not.
All the other people. Mm-hmm.
Now, you've met Mr. Roosevelt. What make you of him?
What are you sniggering at?
What was that?
You just sniggered.
No. The dog. It seems to be crushing my feet.
Oh
my God.
Buster!
Hey!
Your sad devotion to that ancient religion has not helped you conjure up the stolen data tapes. Are giving you clairvoyance enough to find the rebels' hidden fort.
I find your lack of faith disturbing.
Enough of this. Vader, release him.
As you wish.
This bickering is pointless. Now, Lord Vader will provide us with the location of the rebel fortress by the time this station is operational. We will then crush the rebellion with one swift stroke.
Hunt crosses the line. Now he needed to finish third to score enough points to be world champion. But in the confusion here, we're being told that he may have finished fifth.
He finished fifth.
No, quarto. Our lap charts show Hunt in third place. Well, if the scoreboard's right, it means he's just missed out on the championship. Crushing defeat for Hunt after such a heroic drive.
Danny, I like you. And you, Rusty. I mean, you got style. You got brio. You got loyalty. You two are the Morecambe and Wise of the thievery world, but even they went off the boil. You're analog players in a digital world. You're done. Believe me, I would love to go up against Greco and crush him, but it can't be beat.
What do you think, Henry?
Well, as you know, most of my staff have weighed in against this incursion. They believe it will fail to achieve anything fundamental militarily and will result in crushing criticism domestically.
I didn't ask what your staff thinks. What do you think, Henry?
What I think is they're cowards. Their opposition represents the cowardice of the Eastern establishment. They don't realize, as you do, sir, that the communists only respect strength and they will only negotiate in good faith if they fear the madman Richard Nixon.
Exactly. Unpredictability is our best asset.
We've got to take the war, too.
Good evening, Moneypenny.
Good evening, James. And we'll meet you in the Situation Room. I'm to take you straight in.
I've never seen you after hours, Moneypenny. Lovely.
Thank you, James.
Out on some kind of professional assignment, dressing to kill?
You'll find this crushing, 007. When I don't sit at home every night praying for some international incident so I can run down here all dressed up to impress James Bond. I was on a date, if you must know, with a gentleman. We went to the theatre together.
Oh, Moneypenny, I'm devastated. What would I ever do without you?
As far as I can remember, James, you've never had me.
Hope springs eternal.
You know, this sort of behaviour could qualify as sexual harassment.
Really? What's the penalty for that?
Someday you have to make good on your innuendos.
After you, Moneypenny.
No, I insist. You first.
Good evening.
Hey, Larkin. Who's that guy?
That is Cameron Poe, a parolee hitching a ride home.
He's a nobody.
Okay, let's do it.
Willie, nobody on the plane knows your classification. Not even my guards.
Guard Bishop?
Hey, Larkin.
Tell me, Skip. Is the U.S. Marshal Service in the habit of employing annoying, wise-ass bookworm creeps?
Larkin's one of the best we got.
Yeah, well, I still like to crush his larynx with my boot.
Scan him.
For you sports fans out there, there was a lot of action today in college football. Here's what happened in the top 10. UCLA narrowly defeated Washington 19-17. Michigan State crushed Minnesota 42-14. Ohio State beat Iowa 20-10. Michigan blanked Indiana 30-0. It was Notre Dame over North Carolina 27-7. Oklahoma ripped Iowa State 52-0. West Virginia lost to Pittsburgh 26-7.
Lunatic. You know him?
Yeah. We were on the same lunch shift when I was in ninth grade, and he would always say the most random, weird things. And then one day, he was just like, gone. And then Connie Cardullo told me that his parents had to put him in a mental institution.
Why? What did he do?
What do you mean?
Well, they can't put you away just for saying weird things.
You total slut. You've got a crush on him.
What? Please.
You are defending him. You love him. You want to have like 10,000 of his babies.
Shut up.
Hi. My name's Ricky. I just moved next door to you.
What do you want me to do? I said, you people, what do you want me to do? Apologize for it?
That's exactly what I want, Jimmy, an apology.
I'll apologize for it.
That's all I want.
After you apologize for being late, you motherfucking wop cocksucker.
Jimmy, are you out of your fucking mind? I'll apologize for being late after I kidnap your granddaughter, rip her guts out, and send them to you in a fucking impound.
Oh, no.
You think this is a street crime?
In my gut, yeah.
You know my problem with gut feelings? Once you have them, the only evidence you see is the evidence that reinforces your gut feeling. Human nature.
There's no money left in his wallet, and there's been a series of robberies here the last 2 months. You have some reason to think it wasn't a robbery?
Well, Agent Merriweather spent the last 25 years honing his ability to sense danger, to notice anything outside of the ordinary. So for some average street criminal to get the drop on him, yeah, it raises some questions. Not to mention that he's been shot here twice with a 45. I'm gonna take a guess.
Tim, do not move that. Your muscles freeze, you can't breathe. You spasm so hard you break your own back and spit your guts out.
But that's after your skin melts off.
Oh my God.
Well, I think we'd like God on our side at the moment, don't you? So what I'm doing now is removing the guidance system chips so the rocket will splash down after 500 feet. All right, man. You can let go of it. All right, just back away. Just back away.
Sir.
Where are we in Gagan?
Falling up on more victims. Hey, I want to expand the investigation.
Why?
We got a fourth priest. It might be as many as 13.
13?
Yeah.
Who's your source?
Phil Saviano.
Oh, Jesus Christ, Robbie. Yeah, I told Mike that guy's a fucking...
I know. I think Saviano might be legit, Ben.
You want to elaborate on that?
No, not really. It just feels like this thing's stacking up. It's my gut.
Freak luck.
Yeah, freak luck.
Isn't it true? Look at the other guys. Now, they're good fighters, right? They're colorful. They got good records. They fight their guts out for peanuts. But you get a shot at the title.
Well, I'm your friend, Johnny. I was there with you knee deep in all that blood and guts.
I covered your ass more than once. Seems like bailing you out of trouble is going to be a lifetime job for me.
There wouldn't be no trouble except for that king shit cup.
All I wanted was something to eat. But the man kept pushing, sir.
Well, you did some pushing of your own, John.
They drew first blood, not me.
Please take me home. Take me home. Please take me home. Take me home. Please take me home.
There he goes, old blood and guts.
Yeah, our blood. His guts.
Puberty. And nobody fancies me. And if these cheeks get any chubbier, they never will.
Nonsense. I fancy you.
Really?
Yeah. Well, I did before you got so far. Oh,
you see? And unless I'm much mistaken, your job still pays you rather a lot of money, whilst Honey here earns 20 pence a week flogging her guts out in London's worst record store.
Yes! And I haven't got hair. Mm. I've got feathers. And I've got funny goggly eyes. And I'm attracted to cruel men. And actually, no one will marry me because my buzzies have actually started shrinking.
See?
When you're on the ice, you gotta be there. Okay, so take a couple days off, and we'll talk. Listen. When I was your age, I lost my dad, too. I know what you're going through. If you want to come in and talk, want somebody to spill your guts to, or throw the bull around, the door's open.
Smorgasbord.
We never had that kind of trouble in these waters.
Well, what else could have done that to that girl? Boat the belly?
Well, I think possibly, yes, a boating
accident.
That's
not what you told me over the phone.
I was wrong. We'll have to amend our reports.
And you'll stand by
I'll stand by you.
Right. A summer girl goes swimming. Swims out a little far. She tires. Fishing boat comes along.
It's happened before.
I don't think you appreciate the gut reaction people have to these things.
Harry, I appreciate it. I'm just reacting to what I was told.
Martin.
I think he's a bust.
Huh? What? How? Why?
I don't know. Gut feeling. To be honest, Jeff, it's a character thing for me. But look, I have other needs. So if you want to make a trade for six, I can make that happen right now.
You want six? Who are you taking?
Can't. I can't tell you that, Jeff. The question is, do you want to make a trade?
Hey, O'Brien. Shut up.
I told you, it's O'Keefe. Do you know why no one remembers your name? It's because no one wants to remember your name. There's too many Smiths, D'Amatos, and O'Keefes, and O'Briens who show up here replacing Tocoa men. That you dumb replacements got killed in the first place. And they're all like you. They're all piss and vinegar. Where the crowd's at. Let me at them. When do I get to jump into Berlin? 2 days later, there they are. With their blood and guts hanging out. And they're screaming for a medic. Begging for their goddamn mother. Them dumb fucks.
Man, look at your face. I mean, all the things you must be thinking. God, you really hate my guts, don't you? But you know something, Brian? That's all right.
Steven, maybe we should talk about it.
You don't like me because of what? Because I was no genius in the way I raised you. Is that it? Dad was gone. So what was I supposed to do? I mean, you tell me. What was I supposed to do?
Steven. It's okay.
I tried, Brian. I mean, I wanted so many things for you that I couldn't even hope for. Because after that, I had no choices.
I don't feel that's anything to be ashamed of. Well, it is. Yeah, you're right. Don't placate me like I'm your mother, boy. Forgive me, sir, for speaking so bluntly. Those fags make me want to puke my fucking guts out. Me too, son. Yeah, me too.
I made these calls to Barbara from Carolyn's apartment. Late again, kid. This trial's a bitch. I'll catch dinner in town. I just assume you let it go. Barbara sees a phone company subpoena. Now she's gonna bust a gut.
Miss Darrow. Hey, do you hear me? We're gonna be stranded here. Miss Darrow was a great gal. No question. She was a wonderful person. It's a terrible loss, and we're all gonna miss her.
I always knew you were nothing like the tough guy you play on screen. I just never figured you for a coward.
Hey, pal. Hey, wake up. Heroes don't look like me, not in the real world. In the real world, they got bad teeth, a bald spot, and a beer gut. I'm just an actor with a gun who's lost his motivation. Be seeing you.
Not on her tummy, Walt.
Not putting her on her tummy. Put her on her side. You want to hold her back?
Yeah.
Right there. Just in case she decides to do a little spit up, and roll up a nice clean towel like this and put it under.
You know, Hammacher Schlummer makes a proper one of those. It's hypoallergenic.
Well, I think a towel will do.
Uncuff him.
So we still don't know whose side Mike is really on.
Yes, we do. He's the reason I'm still alive. When you get to be president, you understand that being spit on, even betrayed, comes with the job. But it shouldn't come with his or any of his. Now uncuff him.
Back to bed.
Ted, the fact is, Joanna.
Look, the fact is that for the last 6 months, I've been spitting blood to get this agency one of the biggest accounts it's ever had. And at 5 o'clock this afternoon, we got the account. At 8 o'clock, I'm walking home with the vice president who tells me I'm gonna be the next creative director of this apartment. I come through this door to share with my wife with what probably is gonna be one of the five best days of my life, and she looks at me cool as a cucumber and tells me she doesn't want to live with me anymore. Can't you understand what she's done to me?
Yeah. She lost.
What's the matter with you?
With me?
Car feels heavy. You know why? You got the fucking weight of the world on your shoulders.
Look, I got a little problem at school, that's all.
Spit it out.
It's not a big deal, all right? Where are we going? We're going to the Oak Room or something?
If it's not a big deal, why did you say real important stuff? What are you doing, banging the dean's daughter? Ha!
No, I'm in a little trouble.
What kind of trouble?
I saw some guys.
Sir!
It's a miracle. It's impossible.
Calm down, man. Spit it out.
Proof, sir, is complete.
Complete?
You're right, sir. Others who were proved not to transgress by thy example, Milton, Paradise Lost.
You found it?
No, not us, sir. You better read this.
It's with a great sense of privilege I offer myself as a volunteer.
Please, sir, read on.
Enclosed. Please find 1,000 word slips with corresponding quotations from the height and depth of literature. I have derived a key, a type of dictionary within a dictionary that allows the amassing of words with indented quotations. My request is simple, to make your burden light.
Hey, Lucas Flannery.
Place has been in the family since 28. Granddaddy ran it all his life, ain't that right, Granddaddy? Real soon, he's gonna sign it over to me.
The movies nowadays, that's the trouble. Sequels and remakes, bunch of crap. I love that one. Oh.
He's deaf and senile.
Heard that.
Now, these just need some spit and polish. I believe they're digital. Possibly IMAX.
Then we'll ride horses on the beach, right in the surf. Now, but you'll have to do it like a real cowboy, none of that side saddle stuff.
You mean one leg on each side?
Yeah.
Can you show me?
Sure, if you like.
Teach me to ride like a man.
And chew tobacco like a man.
And spit like a man.
What, they didn't teach you that in finishing school?
No.
Well, come on, I'll show you. Let's do it.
Now, you tell me, what is more likely here?
that a message from aliens results in a magical machine that whisks you away to the center of the galaxy to go windsurfing with dear old dad, and then a split second later returns you home without a single shred of proof. Or that your experience is the result of being the unwitting star in the farewell performance of one S.R. Haddon, a man with the means, the motive, and the opportunity to play you, and indeed the rest of us, as pawns in the biggest, the most elaborate, the most expensive hoax of all time.
Madam.
It's tempting, but I can defend my own honor.
But I do so very much want to crush his windpipe.
I've been told, Codman, you must learn to control that impulse. Channel it into other things.
Yes, my lord. Like making beds or cooking food, polishing the silver. I am trying, my lord.
He is a headmaster, very rare breed.
That dude's disturbed. Like, seriously evil, like split personality.
Good.
Cogman?
You know, I never understood why everyone was so crazy about Paris, but it is so beautiful. I can't. I'm sorry, I can't. You know, Nate and I just split up a couple days ago, and I can't. Mm. I've had too much wine and my hearing, vision, judgment's impaired. No, I barely know you. I'm in a strange city. I am out of excuses.
Thank God.
For a split second, the thought crossed my mind that he really didn't want me. That it was easy to walk away.
You gotta feed the geese to keep the blood flowing. Mm-hmm. I keep the rhythm below the belt.
Done.
This is not a tip. This is a prescription, trust me. Mm-hmm. If you don't, you will fall out of balance, split your differential, and tip the fuck over. Or worse yet, I've seen this happen, implode.
No, I don't want to implode, sir.
No, you don't.
I'm in it for the long run, you know?
Yeah, implosions are ugly.
Yeah.
Pop off to the bathroom, work one out anytime you can, and when you get really good at it, you'll fucking be stroking it, and you'll be thinking about money. Second.
That's smooth on the home front, so I'll tone it down a little, all right?
Tone down what, motherfucker?
Right. Never mind. Hey, when you become a big shot lawyer, you think you could find us an elevator building, maybe? What did you get robbed? Not exactly.
Wait. Did she split on you? Oh, God. Oh.
We have had the privilege of witnessing the greatest exhibition of guts and stamina in the history of the ring.
It's been a while since I was in a fight. I panicked. Fell back like you broke my foot.
Henri, old fool.
Well, that damn Cuba cigar got me riled up.
Charlie?
You too, wait here.
Hold on there, Charlie. Hold on.
I ain't looking over my shoulder the rest of my days.
Charlie?
You said we was gonna kill them all. I aim to do just that.
Well, kill them, not murder them.
Splitting hairs, ain't you, boss?
Hey, everyone. Let's put down the dishes for a second. I need to talk to you. Here's the deal. I hired you three under America Works. And as much as we can use the manpower, I can't afford it if the program gets ended. I might be able to afford to keep two of you if you split shifts, but I can't keep all three.
A storm.
Man has climbed Mount Everest.
gone to the bottom of the ocean. He has fired rockets to the moon, split the atom, achieved miracles in every field of human endeavor, except crime.
Melanie wanted to get her ears pierced, but of course her mother said no. So she threw a fit and smashed her Johnny Mathis Greatest Hits album. And she got grounded, so now she can't come to my pajama sleepover party.
Things were unfolding quite nicely.
Well, hey, what are you doing for your science project this year?
That is, until my supposed best friend, Garrett Einbinder, took an interest in Sherry himself.
I was thinking of showing how split ends react with different kind of hair conditioners.
That's fascinating.
What? The bell sounds, so Conlon survives the 12th round.
What a finish. If that round goes another 30 seconds, we may have a new champion.
An unforgettable fight on an unforgettable night. He's no longer just the namesake of Apollo Creed. He's the living embodiment.
Ladies and gentlemen, a round of applause for these two warriors in the ring. To the winner by split decision. And still, the undefeated champion of the world, Pretty Ricky.
Hey, Donnie, you are...
I don't see what you're going to prove here. The man said he saw the boy running out.
Well, let's see if the details bear him out. As soon as the body hit the floor, he said he heard footsteps upstairs running toward the front door. Heard the upstairs door open, the footsteps start down the stairs. He said he got to his own front door as fast as he could, and he swore it couldn't have been more than 15 seconds. Now, the killer began running immediately.
Yeah, but maybe he did.
The old man said he did.
You ought to be in Atlantic City at that hair splitters convention.
Hey, why don't you stop making smart remarks all the time?
Oh, huh? My friend.